I don't know what exactly I'm going to title this video exactly. I'll probably think of something, but it was something that happened that I wanted to speak about, and I don't think enough people talk about it, especially in the Black community, because they feel like it's, you know, I don't know if they feel like it's taboo or it doesn't happen as much in the Black community, but it does. And I saw something that went across my Facebook page, and I decided to speak on it. Basically, Black Lives Matter activist Marshawn McCarl fatally shoots himself on Ohio State House steps, okay? Let me read you guys what happened. The activist worked to organize protests in Ohio after Mike Brown's shooting in 2014. Okay, it says Black Lives Matter Marshawn McCarl, like I said, reportedly shot himself Monday in front of the Ohio State House building in Columbus, Ohio. This is what he wrote, okay, before he killed himself. My demons won today. I'm sorry. My demons won today. I'm sorry. Were the last words the activist wrote on Facebook just hours before he was found dead. He also left this string of haunting text tweets behind. If we don't have to live through hell just to get to heaven, I'ma stay right here with you. He also wrote, let the record show that I pissed on the state house before I left. McCarl, who just recently attended the NAACP Image Awards with his mom, worked to organize protests in Ohio, like I said, after the Mike Brown shooting in 2014. And this is him right here for the, oh goodness, that's him right there for those of you who want to see him, okay? Along with being a vocal Black Lives Matter advocate, the young leader founded two community service organizations, a mentorship program called Pursuing Our Dreams, and a charity for the homeless called Feed the Streets. McCarl was known for his compassion towards the homeless, urging people to go beyond just giving food. The 23-year-old who was named Radio One's hometown champion for his work, the nomination detailed McCarl's unrelenting passion for those less fortunate. Marshawn stresses the importance of having conversations with the people we feed, because they'll get hungry in 2 hours. But a good conversation will carry them over for a lifetime, which is so true. I say that all the time. That's why a lot of times, even when I was working at the homeless shelter, you know, you sit there and you try to talk to people because you never know what people are going through. But anyway, basically what this video is going to be talking about is basically the mental health of a lot of African-American people. A lot of people really don't, I don't know if people think it's taboo that, you know, people say that a lot of African-American people commit suicide. A lot of African-American people have mental health issues and things like that. And I want people to understand that by saying that a person has mental health issues does not mean that they're mentally retarded or anything like that. It just means that sometimes they go through things emotionally that, you know, it takes a toll on them a little bit more than someone else. That's really all that means, to be brutally honest with you. But I wanted to talk about, you know, the fact that a lot of people say, well, he seemed so happy, you know, the fact that he was an advocate for Black Lives Matter and he was an advocate for police brutality and things like that. A lot of people felt like, you know, he, you know, was advocating for other people's lives, but he felt he had no value in his own life. I want you guys to take note of his last words that he wrote on Facebook. My demons won today. I'm sorry. Y'all know how I talk about, you know, I suffer from depression and things like that. It's no secret. I say that all the freaking time because I feel like it's important for me to say that. Because the reason why I feel like it's important for me to say that is because a lot of people see me get on these videos and I look like this happy-go-lucky person, and I'm always smiling, I'm always cheering, and I'm always making jokes and things like that. And sometimes, like I said, I get on here and I make these videos because people ask me all the time, Thick Chick, what made you get on YouTube? Girl, sometimes my day used to be so dark to the point where I didn't want to get out of the freaking bed. And by me getting up and recording a video made me, I don't know what type of triggers it had for me, but they were good triggers, okay? And they making YouTube videos changed my life, okay? In more ways than one. I can honestly and truly say that. I say that all the time. But I want people to understand that sometimes I had the perfect photo that I shared on my Facebook like page, not on my you know, just my actual Thick Chick Vlogs page, my actual Thick Chick Vlogs like page a while ago. It was the perfect, you know, depiction of a person who suffers from depression. Okay. It was a photo of this man who rolled out of bed. He was very, very, you know, it was had this dark shadow over him, and he looked slumped over. He just looked worn, okay? And then he got up to put on his clothes, but what he zipped up was this, it was a flesh of another person, okay, that was smiling. A lot of people don't understand that sometimes people can appear to be happy-go-lucky and all giddy and just the funniest person ever, but you never know what's going on in that person's life, okay? I just think that it's very, very important for people who suffer from things like this to speak out about it. Talk about it. Tell somebody about it. Don't feel like you're alone in the situation. There are several people, okay? Thousands and thousands of people out there that are just like you, okay? I've had people who reach out to me because they tell me they go through the same things, and by us just having a conversation makes them feel better. And I can honestly say, honestly and truly, when I talk to a person who goes through some of the same things that I go through from time to time, it makes me feel better. It really honestly and truly does. Now, the whole suicidal thoughts thing, back a long time ago, long time ago, I remember thinking to myself, I wonder what, well, hell, I can't say I wonder what life would be like, but I wonder if I would be better off dead. I've said that to myself before a long time ago, girl. I haven't had those types of thoughts in 10 years, girl. And back then, even just the mere thought, I just thought about it. It wasn't nothing like I was just planning to kill myself or anything like that. But I just want people to understand and know that mental health issues, suicide and depression and all that type of stuff is very common in the Black community. You may not see it a lot, but it's very common in the Black community as well. And I think that's a really, really sad situation that this young man was an advocate for, you know, feeding homeless people. He was an advocate for, like I said, police brutality, Black Lives Matter, et cetera, et cetera. Whether or not whatever you feel about Black Lives Matter, a lot of people feel like Black Lives Matter is a hate group. That's your opinion. That's not what we're here to discuss today. We're here to discuss mental health issues in the African American community and the fact that this young man appeared to a lot of people as being happy-go-lucky and a person who was, you know, all about helping others, but he never got a chance to help himself with the issues that he was dealing with the demons that he was fighting. And when I tell you, family, sometimes fighting demons, okay, it's like a physical fight, literally. You're not literally fighting with nobody, but having to coax yourself to just live your day-to-day life sometimes. Sometimes if you suffer from depression, sometimes you may just, girl, you may be one of the happiest people ever. You literally may just have a great, honestly and truly, a great day. And the next day you might just wake up and you just might be in that slump, okay? It's a real thing that happens in our community. And I want people to understand that you're not alone in the situation. You really, honestly and truly, are not. You never have to feel like you're alone in the situation, because there are people out there that are just like you. Whether you need to, you know, contact somebody on in your family and maybe they can get you some help, or hell, girl, if you're watching this video and you want somebody to talk to, email me. My links, everything of my contact information is always down in the description box down below. I will tell people not to message me on YouTube, because I really, honestly, I don't even check that for real. I check it, girl, every blue moon. So a lot of times people send me messages to my YouTube inbox and I don't see it. I mean, because I just don't check it like that. But my email automatically comes to my phone. Now make sure you put some type of subject or something in the headline, because it'll go, a lot of my stuff in my email, for some reason, if I have not responded to you, a lot of stuff goes to my spam folder and I don't even get a notification for it. But if you message me on Facebook, that's probably another easy way for you to get in contact with me. If you just want somebody to talk to, because sometimes people, you know, just want a listening ear, somebody to talk to about whatever it is that they're going through. I just want people to know that they're not alone. Even people that say that they watch my videos sometimes, because I give them a good kiki. I mean, sometimes a lot of the shit that I say, people tell me I'm funny as fuck. Let me tell y'all something, family. And this is the honest to God truth, okay? A lot of times, half of the shit that I say, I don't even realize I didn't say the shit until I'm editing the video. And then I'd be like, damn, did I really say that? And even then, I don't watch the video all the way through. And y'all will leave a comment down in the comment section below about something that I said. And I'd be like, did I really say that? And I had to go back and watch it. And I'd be like, damn, you really said that motherfucking shit. I mean, the shit just flows for real, honestly and truly. But I am so humble that you guys watch my videos. For those of you that are, you know, if you're going through something for that day, or if you just go through something, period, and my videos help you, I want to say that I am so humble, and I want you guys to know that never feel like you can't message me, because you can pretty much ask anybody. People that have messaged me on Facebook, it may take me a second to respond, but sometimes I respond immediately. Sometimes it might take me an hour or two. Sometimes it might take me a day or two, because if I'm doing something else, if I'm in the middle of doing something else, I might look at it and be like, okay, So if you see me have read your message, don't think that I'm ignoring you, because a lot of times I'll sit there and read it and I'll go back to work and I'll be like, okay, I'm going to respond to that person when I get done, and it just slips my mind. So if you have messaged me and I have not messaged you back, feel free to send me another message and I will definitely respond. But I want everybody out there to know, if you're going through anything, I don't care if you're black, white, I know that, you know, I'm just speaking on the African American community right now, because I know that a lot of people feel like it's taboo to even speak on mental health issues in the African American community. I know that other races go through it as well, but I'm speaking on this particular situation because I saw the story write up about this young man. I just want people to know that I'm not just saying mental health issues occur in the African-American community, because of course that would be, you know, come on, that's common sense. But like I said, if anybody's going through anything, if you want to talk to me, or if you just want to talk about it down in the comments, it don't even matter, girl. Talk to somebody. And also, if you're feeling suicidal, there are numbers you can call. I don't know, you know, the specifics about the numbers. I've never had to call the suicide hotline or anything like that. I don't even know the process or what they do, girl. Some people say that they're afraid to call because they feel like the people are going to call the police. I don't even know how the stuff works. But you need to talk to someone, okay? If you ever feel like you're at a point where you just cannot go on any longer, never feel like the solution is taking your life. You are worth fighting for, especially if you feel like you know, your children, if you have children, your children are worth fighting for. Anybody, trust me, you don't want to put your family through that type of stuff, okay? If you are a person who suffers from depression and you just, you know, you have the thought in the back of your mind that maybe you'll be better off leaving here, trust me, your family, you're going to hurt your family worse. Girl, if you go out by taking your own life, just get some help. Talk to someone. Hell, talk to me. I'll leave the link, the numbers to the suicide hotline and all that stuff down in the comment section below. I just thought I needed to speak on that today. Something spoke to my spirit, girl, because depression is very, very real. Suicide is very running rampant in the African-American community as well. It's not just happening in other races. It's happening in the African-American community as well. And just because a person puts on a pretty face, a smile, and all that stuff does not mean that they're okay. It really doesn't. But I thank God that he has brought me out of a lot of dark places. Yes, I still have my days to where I'm feeling down and, you know, I might not want to get out of the bed. It doesn't happen as often. It's not like it used to be. But yes, I do have those days sometimes to where I'm like, ugh. But trust me, when I tell you, Lord, I thank you, because there's I'm nowhere near where I used to be back in the day when I used to be. Every single day was a struggle. Just crying every single day. Hell, I sit there thinking to myself, why the fuck are you crying, girl? It used to be like that. And now I might have those days every blue moon. And it's nothing compared to how it used to be. And part of that is attributed to me doing these YouTube videos and talking to y'all and Kiki and girl. The shit is, y'all, I have a good time here on YouTube talking to you guys. And I really honestly and truly thank each and every one of you guys. Girl, we're almost at 30,000 subscribers on this channel. Can you believe we're almost at 30,000 subscribers? I told y'all 2016 was going to be my biz naive. I'm dead serious about that. Yes, I'm very, very serious. 2016 is going to be my biz naive. Just sizzling. You guys give this video a thumbs up. Make sure you leave comments down in the comment section below. You guys can go over to, you can just type in the guy's name or Black Lives Matter activists commit suicide. I'm pretty sure it'll pop up and you guys can read the story on it. Just know that mental illness is a thing in the African-American community, and suicide is very real in the African-American community as well. And don't forget that you can message me if you're going through anything, and I will not hesitate to message you back. We can talk, girl. We can talk. Girl or guy, we can talk, okay? Just know we can talk about whatever you want to talk about. You can talk my ear off, because y'all know I talk y'all ear off. Just says it. So I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Bye, family.